No, sir.
Nothing.
Sir, in Tamil Nadu, especially in Madurai, we don't get, we have a power cut for 8 hours every day. We don't get water to drink. We don't have electricity. They are not even providing basic amenities. Then how are they going to take care of other logistics? And I did not take up any initiative in approaching for government help or government grants, because I had a couple of experience from my side. When a good grant was sanctioned to Akshaya, they asked about 40% as bribe from the amount. So how can we account it? How can we give that? So it is always a problem. And what happens when organization is totally dependent on government bodies? During the time of election, they will ask you to campaign for them.
Can you? Is there any plan or already you spoke to Akshaya Patra who handles the midday meal program?
Yes, Akshaya Patra is an organization in Bangalore. They have a central kitchen in organizing the midday meal that is for school children.
Yeah.
They have a tie-up with the government also that is for the school children. That project is totally different because we here feed the mentally ill people on the roads. They feed the school children.
Yeah, if we can tie up with them because they are doing it for some other organizations in AP also. They have this infrastructure set up.
True, sir. But they deal with children. Their mission is to deal with kids. We deal with the mentally ill people, old people. See, you have lot of orphanages, lot of blind schools, lot of physically challenged homes in India, but the mentally ill free homes are very less. Except a couple of things which has been run by the government, like Kid Park and something like that. So these people are neglected. Suppose if somebody wants to celebrate their birthday, their first intention will be go to an orphanage. But these people are on the roads. Orphanages, somehow or the other, they get food. At least government will supply rice. They get food to eat, at least one meal. But imagine the situation of people on the roads. There's nobody to do that.
Did you approach any saints? Like there are so many gurus, or they are doing their own best in at their interest, right? Did you approach that this is the root cause, this is a real problem happening and you are experiencing all these things, whether they can help somewhere?
I have approached a couple of gurus to learn yoga. Apart from that, I have not approached gurus.
But usually, if it has to be done at a larger scale, maybe the Babas actually can help, right?
If it
has to be done in a larger scale, like across India, like if this concept has to be expanded to other cities, usually the Babas, they have a lot of money, right? Like they can help, right? So
I can't get who's Babas. I know who's Babas.
Like,
Shri Baba, Sai Baba.
Yeah.
You are talking about which Baba?
Shirdi Puttabar Sai Baba. Or...
I have no comments on that.
Again, we are wasting our energies by looking at other things. Right?
No,
we are wasting our energies by looking at other things. Like better to focus on what you are doing.
Okay.
Hats off to your tremendous job, Mr. Krishnan.
Thank you.
I have a quick question. It suddenly will be a seed of inspiration to so many other people, youngsters of similar kind. Since you are doing it with dedication in one small city, have you ever come across any other individuals who are interested in your model, how you are exactly doing, and are they doing anything similar to that? There are more Krishnans like that, including us, but is there anything that you know of?
Yes, sir. There were almost about more than a couple of dozens people who approached me that they want to start the same thing in Hyderabad, in Vijayawada, in Chennai, in Kerala. So what happens, they do it for 1 week or 10 days, and then they have some personal issues to go ahead. I don't want to say that only I am doing such things in this world, but the amount, they come and approach us, they say that I want to start something in Hyderabad. So I leave all my work here, take a train, travel 3 days, go to Hyderabad, and tell them how to do, what to do. They do it for 1 week and they stop it. The main reason for they are not able to do it is because these mentally ill people don't thank you. See, as a human being, psychologically, what intention we will have when we do good for somebody, when we do something good for someone, we expect at least a smile or a thank as a token of appreciation from them. But these people don't even smile at you. So you lose hope. I've been doing it. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning. I'm not sleeping at all. I've been working for you. I'm giving food for you for the last 10 days. You don't want to even give me a smile. At last, we will have that intention to do. I can't get your question. I'm sorry.
Do you plan to spread the organization to other countries?
Right now we are doing it in Madurai. So once when the home is operational, we need to monitor how it is going there. So after a couple of years, when somebody is really interested to start a chapter somewhere, I will definitely join hands with them.
People and how long they stay, and then you turn them back on to the road. And it occurred to me, I had that beautiful story that Lata did out of my car. So I handed it out. I'd like to just say a quick word on it.
For sure.
You sure? Okay. Yeah, loud enough as it is. The good doctor offered a question to Krishnan early on about the fact that you take these people in and you give them compassion, you give them hope, you give them, in fact, if I had just, I just want to grab one copy, I want to quote something. This kind of, if you want a job description for Krishnan, this would be a good one. His job is to give food to the hungry, to restore their body. Give love to the forgotten, to restore their spirit. And give care to the downtrodden, to restore their dignity. And this story, which is, the words are from one of our volunteers, in fact, the lady who is the executive director of Akshaya USA, Lata Kalaga. She wrote the story, and I kind of dressed it up with some pictures. And it's a story about one person that Krishnan brought in, gave compassion, gave care, gave food. It's a happy story, and it's a sad story, because as you ask that question right now, those people are cared for and returned to their home, which is the street. That's why we are all very anxious to complete the Akshaya home so that we bring them in. They have a real place to go, a roof over their head, a meal every day, and compassion around them. Grazie.
Yes, sir.
Hats off to your work.
Thank you,
sir. I'm very honored. How many people have been rehabbed and are on their own feet now?
Almost in this 10 years, we have rehabilitated closer to 15 to 16 people. They are now working in small factories around Madurai. They earn about 3,000 rupees per month, and out of that, they contribute 1,500 rupees to Akshaya.
Wow.
They were actually declared as mentally ill people, and they were sleeping inside the big cement garbage. The dress obviously would have become black in color. From the functions, the used plantain leaves have been thrown onto them. And for hunger, they were been eating that. They were just like dogs on streets. But now they are completely rehabilitated. They are very, very well. They are not under medication. And all those 16 people were being rehabilitated, not even giving them a Tylenol. Just by talking to them, counseling them, we gave some work for them in the kitchen. We spent hours together for more than several years, and they thought, okay, there are some people to care for us on this planet, and they came back to normal. And I'm sure that more than 80% of the population can be rehabilitated, and I have the complete confidence to make Madurai district a destitute-free city.